Because of this dam behind me and hydropower station, the river was transformed, which resulted in the destruction of habitats for birds.
The natural flowing river here was really beautiful. It was really wide and with lots of natural gravel islands, so the common terns nested there. Mm-hmm. And after everything was destroyed,
it was very clear that without intervention, we would lose common tern as a breeder here on the lake.
This part of the river Drava was flooded when the dam was built in 1977. Before, it had many small islands where the birds were nesting, but after the water got up, all islands disappeared and number of birds starts to diminish. Little tern is now extinct from this area. Stone curlew disappeared in the whole Slovenia. To prevent this from happening and restore the natural breeding and nesting sites, organization DOPPS start building artificial islands, which now are solely and exclusively reserved for birds.
I'm in Slovenia at the Lake Ptuj, and today's the day when we're gonna visit these small islands for maintenance together with many volunteers. So, let's go.
All three targeted species of birds which nests on this island, common tern, Mediterranean gull and black-headed gull, are somewhere in Africa right now. And it's no wonder why they're migrating when it's so cold and foggy here.
Here is the largest colony of black-headed gull. Approximately 1,000 pairs breed here on this island.
On this small one?
Yes, yes. This one was meant for breeding for common terns. Gravel layer is missing here. Uh-huh. Therefore, it became more suitable for black-headed gull. With no management, in next year we have here no breeding gulls. So if we skip just 1 year, it's over. Uh-huh. And it is the only breeding site of black-headed gull in the country.
In the whole Slovenia?
Yes.
Wow, so it's very important. So
it is.
Our task is pretty simple. We're gonna clean all of the island from the reef and long grass.
Here you can see the fence. It goes all around the perimeter, exactly in the middle.
And that's especially for the small chicks when they hatch, so they don't fall from the island. And also there is some wooden chips like this, which also create better habitat for nesting. We're working here on this island, and there's another one, then there's other team. And there are many more small artificial islands and platforms.
And this one is first one that was built for purpose for the colonial nesting birds. But then we saw that it's overgrowing really fast, and we need a lot of work to keep it, especially for a common tern that really needs like bare ground and gravel. Now we left this island only for black-headed gulls, and the big gravel islands are now for common terns. Mm-hmm. And you see this is an interesting fact, that pile of wood there, yeah. It's a beaver. And now beaver also helps us with the removal of vegetation, yeah, so the nature helps too.
So it's getting less foggy, it's nice. But also we have finished this island, look. It's now clear and beautiful, and we're gonna go to our boat. Oh, right now, oh, here's some birds. So now we're gonna go to our boat, and we're gonna move to another island, bigger one. There's actually two big ones where all of the teams will meet and will continue.
All of the targeted birds are away right now. Of course, it would be nicer to be here in the summer when it's warm, no fog, and we can see the birds. But in this case, we will disturb them, and we don't want to do it.
Look at these electric lines. We're going there now, inspect, and the guys even arrange them so birds can nest on the electric lines platforms.
We noticed that the chicks, when they hatch from the eggs, they start, if they fall from the platform, they just drown because they cannot go back up. So we arranged the mesh, so all around there is a wire and a mesh. On this one, each year it's occupied by a single yellow-legged gull.
Just one?
Just one, yeah, because it's really territorial and aggressive, so it has this platform, is reserved for him. And the other one on the other side, up to 20 black-headed gulls.
Now we came to pick up 5 guys from this tiny island, and they managed to clear it in just 2 hours. And there is the one we were working on. Slowly we're gonna move everybody from the islands to the last one.
Because we have only one boat, we need to do many trips to transport people from island to island.
So this one is completely different island, and you can see it's all in pebbles, and that's the largest one. And also most of the people were here, so they're already finished. They're gonna be transported to the last island. And yeah, it's interesting how every island is a bit unique. It's a bit different ecosystem, artificially made. There are also like these slabs, it's wooden slabs. They hold the island together so it don't erode.
All 3 colonial species breed here. Mediterranean gull, black-headed gull, and common tern, yes. In parallel with construction of the islands, also the populations increased. Breeding population of common tern is around 150 to 170 pairs. Black-headed gull, close to the 1,000 breeding pairs, and the Mediterranean gull, the 80 to 90 pairs.
So this area is very important for
Yeah, it is, because for both gull species, these are actually the only breeding nesting sites in Slovenia. We have no other locations at all.
I think that's the best island because look, it got security cameras, also solar panels, and that's for protection of the birds actually, because the island itself is protected area and no people allowed to be present on this island. So the birds are protected here not only from natural predators but also from humans. And yeah, you can see how well this island is fenced, but they also got really cool stuff here. It's like these constructions, they're all around here, and that's also for small chicks to protect them from sun, from rain, to give them some shelter. And with this simple device, the survival rate really increasing. And also there's a viewing tower for bird watchers. And I guess the best time to come here will be in May, not in November. Okay, that's another island, quite bigger. Yeah, we're gonna do the same stuff here, clean the reeds.
We proposed to the director of DEM, which is a hydropower company, build a breeding island for birds. And they built it. It was built out of sediment from the lake. The first idea to use sediment for something useful,
that's nice.
For biodiversity.
Here's again several eggs, and for some reasons they're unhatched. And the thing is, they stink so badly I can't even describe, but it's really awful. I think this is the worst part of this job. These islands were made specially for birds, but in reality it's habitat for many different species. Of course plants and insects, but also beavers and even mouse.
I'm doing it from a really young age. I think I was like 13 maybe when I first joined this action, and it's not just, you know, something that you click or sign a petition, you actually do something and that has an effect in nature. And in the next spring you can see the birds returning, nesting here, and it's really nice that nature somehow repays you with something that you contributed to.
As soon as we finished, the sun goes up, it becomes warmer, and the fog is gone. That's funny. So I came to this birdwatching tower at the opposite side of the lake. They've got a calendar of departure and arrival of the birds. And of course, nice view to the islands. Thank you. I haven't worked that much because there were so many volunteers, which of course amazing. I enjoyed doing something and then to see results straight away. Just right now I've seen some swans which went already to the cleared island. If you want to volunteer with DOPPS in Slovenia, the links will be under this video. And actually I did very similar project in Bulgaria last year with pelicans. So if you're still watching this video, that's amazing. I really appreciate it. You can support me by sharing this video, subscribe to my channel or joining me on my Patreon. Thank you for watching and be brave to act.